Hello, and welcome to the National Biodiversity Cryobank of Canada. The Cryobank, which opened about 2 years ago, is a unique type of collection here at the Canadian Museum of Nature. Our other collections contain specimens that look like this. These specimens preserve the morphology of these organisms, so they tell us what they look like, and that's really important information for understanding biodiversity. But these preservation methods don't preserve DNA molecules very well. And because of that, we established this collection here. Here we store tissue samples. So animal tissue samples we store in small 2 milliliter tubes like this. And this might be muscle or organ tissue, which are good sources of DNA. For plant tissues, we store them in envelopes like this. So when our researchers are up in the Arctic, for example, they'll collect some nice green tissue, put an envelope like this, and this is a good source of DNA. We also have one other type of sample here, and that's called environmental DNA, or eDNA. So I want to imagine that you're in the ocean, and there's all the animals and plants in that ocean, small and large aquatic microorganisms. Now, all of those organisms are shedding DNA constantly, and that DNA floats to the top of the ocean. And we can capture that DNA by scooping up a liter of that water. Now, what we do is we concentrate the DNA that's in the ocean water by pumping it through a filter, like this one here. And that concentrates the DNA onto this filter, and that's our eDNA sample, which we can then fold up and put into one of our sample tubes. So this becomes a DNA fingerprint of all of the organisms, the DNA of all of the organisms in the ocean at that time. I like to think of each sample here in the cryobank as a book of information written in the language of DNA. DNA, the genetic code, is written in the language of A, C, G, and T. And it's the order of these four letters in the molecule that give the DNA its meaning. Here at the Museum of Nature, we have a lab where we use the tools and techniques of biotechnology to unlock this information. Now, this information is really important for biodiversity science. It lets us answer all kinds of questions, like, what is a species? How are species related to one another? It can also tell us information about the health of populations to let us make good decisions about conservation practices. If we just left our tissue samples out at room temperature, they'd go rotten, just like if you were to leave food out of the refrigerator. And so, to preserve the DNA molecules, we keep our tissue samples cold, very, very cold. Here we are at one of our freezers that maintains a temperature of minus 160 degrees Celsius. So at this temperature, minus 160 degrees, most molecular movement has stopped. And this means that there'll be no molecular decay. The DNA information is locked in time. Here at the Cryobank, researchers from within the museum or around the world can borrow one of our samples to unlock that DNA information. In this way, the Cryobank supports biodiversity research that will deepen our understanding of the natural world.